Just by running this shortcut, I can create an entire audio podcast without saying a word. Not only that, but it will be using my voice, and I've even published a full episode to Apple Podcasts and to Spotify. Everything about it is generated by AI. The artwork was made by DALL-E, the title and description by ChatGPT, and even the audio episode you can listen to right now is a summary of the news using my voice. Now let's be real, if you listen to it, it's not gonna sound like me, or it's not gonna sound natural if you listen to more than like 5 seconds. I'll tell you what, here's 5 seconds of what it sounds like.
Listening to Apple News today, the date is November 28th, 2023, and here is the news. Today, Apple Books introduced their year in review feature.
Now you can tell it's AI generated, but it's actually a professional voice clone of my voice made with 11 Labs. I did a whole video on this, but I've uploaded hours of audio to 11 Labs of my voice from different podcasts and trained a voice to sound at least a little like me. If you want to see that side-by-side comparison of my professionally cloned AI voice and myself, check out this video above or the link is in the description. But I wanted to see if I could actually use ChatGPT to summarize news articles and then generate my own podcast in my own voice, reading those articles, and create a daily news show without ever speaking a word. And I was able to do it. So I'm gonna walk through this shortcut step by step in a moment, but basically I'm pulling news from an RSS feed, namely Apple's Newsroom. I'm using ChatGPT to summarize the news articles, and then 11 Labs actually has an API that you can use directly inside shortcuts. And with that API, I can generate audio files from text without ever leaving the Shortcuts app, and that audio file can then be saved to my iCloud drive, and I just uploaded that directly to my podcast host. Not only that, but this shortcut can then use ChatGPT again to summarize those news articles and create an episode title and description, and even format the links that I used. And everything you see here from the episode title, the episode description, and the links in the show were all generated from this one shortcut, and all through AI. I didn't write or say a word. And before we go any further, there are definitely some questionable ethical considerations with something like this. I'm using Apple's Newsroom articles. I didn't think they would mind me summarizing. Sorry, Apple, if you're watching. But of course, I would not recommend or condone pulling random articles from other news sources, using ChatGPT to summarize it, and then making a podcast on your own. Don't do that. But if you have news articles that you have written, or you're trying to make a podcast from a website that you curate, then a shortcut like this can actually generate an audio podcast from the things you have written, and it happens in just a few taps. It actually happens really fast. Now, I actually had ChatGPT title this podcast episode. There were some okay names. I went with Digital Pulse, not a great name, but it's something. And I also had ChatGPT write the description for this podcast. I literally wrote not a word. I just asked it to make a title and description for a tech news style podcast, and this is what it gave me. Likewise, this artwork is based on a similar prompt using DALL-E. It also used the Apple logo over and over again, and it just would not stop using the Apple logo if I put Apple anywhere in the prompt. So I had to do something very generic, and this is what it came up with. And did I have to publish it to Apple Podcasts and Spotify? Probably not, but I felt like to be truly thorough, I just needed to go ahead and create a full-on podcast with the audio generated from 11 Labs. So the two applications I'm using is ChatGPT on my iPad or iPhone. You can also use the SGPT shortcut from Federico Vitici, and I have a whole video on how I use that shortcut to summarize my podcast episodes and help me format my podcast show notes. You can check out that video above or in the description. But I'm using the actual GPT app because it takes less taps and interaction to actually get you your summaries. That means you can only run this shortcut on your iPad or your iPhone. Now I will put a link to this shortcut down in the video description, but I'll have to strip my 11 Labs API key and my voice ID. If you create an account on 11 Labs, you do have to pay for the service to get access to the API, but you can find your API key by going to your profile tab, and then you can copy your API key there. Then you can create an instant or professionally cloned voice. Professionally cloned voice takes several weeks, and then you'll also need that unique ID to use in the shortcut. Now let's jump into the shortcut. I've started the shortcut with a Get RSS Items action. This is the Apple Newsroom RSS, and I have a Get 10 of the latest items. Next, I have the Choose from RSS Items, and I also have the option to Select Multiple. And if I select multiple stories, it will send those multiple stories to the ChatGPT app to summarize. I also get the URLs from the chosen items and set a variable to URLs. I know with magic variables and shortcuts, you don't necessarily need to do that, but I just like it for organization. Next, I choose a repeat with each action, and it's going to repeat this with every URL I selected from that RSS feed. This is the get details from article action, and I choose to get the body of the article with this. Then I have a text block, and here's the prompt that I'm using, and this is going to go to ChatGPT. I'm asking it to summarize the article as though I'm a news anchor, and then I put the variable of the body text here at the bottom of this text block. Then I can add the Ask ChatGPT action here, and it's going to send that text to ChatGPT to summarize. I'm using ChatGPT 4, and I'm starting a new chat each time. That's all the repeat action does, and then I combine those results so I have one big block of text. From there, I also have an action that formats the date. It's going to get today's date in the long style. And then I have one more text block because this is going to be the introduction to my podcast. This is what 11 Labs is going to use to create an audio file. That's the little podcast introduction, and it'll say today's date. And then that's the combined text of all the ChatGPT article summaries. And then this step right here is what 11 Labs uses to create the audio content. I'll show you that in more detail in a second, but let's just run this so you get an idea of what it does. When I hit play, I'll see a menu pop up of all the different articles from Apple's newsroom. I'll just select one article for right now, this emergency SOS, and click done. What that's doing is getting the body text of that article. It's sending that to ChatGPT with the prompt that I gave it. It's going to add the little introduction and the date, send that to 11 Labs, and generate an audio file. It's actually going to preview it here on the iPad.
You're listening to Apple News Today. The date is November 28th, 2023, and here is the news. Today marks the one-year anniversary of Apple's revolutionary emergency SOS via satellite service.
I'm still working on the parameters of the 11 Labs API. I can't get it to sound as good as it does when I generate it on the website, but it's right here in Shortcuts. It's pretty wild. I added that play sound action just so we could preview it here, but for the actual podcast, I removed that, and it will just save that MP3 file that 11 Labs generated to iCloud. Comes up with a menu on where to save that, and I choose my desktop. And if I had chosen multiple articles, it would have summarized all those articles and created one big audio file, just summarizing each one right after another. Now that's the audio file, but I also want this shortcut to create show notes. To do that, I start a second portion of this shortcut. This is going to be a repeat command with all the URLs of the articles I chose up at the top. It's going to get the title of each article I selected, and it's going to format that into HTML. It will put the title of the article here and the link here. This way it's ready to make into show notes. I'll combine those results here, and before I put it all together, I have one more ChatGPT prompt. I use the combined text as the prompt, and then ask ChatGPT to write a podcast episode title and description based on all the articles together. Once ChatGPT returns that, I have an entire HTML text block where it formats the description, the links, everything ready to go, and copies that to my clipboard. Let's do it one more time. Now it's going through the process again, summarizing it with ChatGPT. It's going to send it to 11 Labs, and then we'll also see it format the show notes. This window pops up, choosing where I want to save the audio file generated by 11 Labs. Now it's asking ChatGPT to summarize, give me a title and description for this podcast episode. There's the title and description. And now I have an HTML formatted version of my episode show notes, and I can just put this in my podcast host. If I had selected up to 5, 6, or 7 articles, I would have had all those links in the HTML, and all my show notes are ready to go. To use 11 Labs here in the shortcut, you're going to use a get contents of URL action. Once you add this action, this is the URL you need to get the contents of. Where it says your voice ID, that's actually where you're going to pull from your 11 Labs account. If you go to the Voice Lab page for 11 Labs, roll over the ID field, and that's the voice ID you need to paste where it says your voice ID. Keep that full URL before it. Now, if we expand the get contents action, you do need all of these fields. Your API key, this is where you'll put the API key from your profile page in 11 Labs. You need these two fields just like they are. And down in the request body, for text, you want to choose the text variable that you place right before the action. That's what 11 Labs will use to create the audio file. And these are some parameters that aren't required. You don't even need to have these in order for it to work. But I'm trying to fine-tune all the settings for this voice. And I'll put a link to the 11 Labs API documentation if you'd like to play around with that. But that's the only step you need to use the 11 Labs API and generate an audio file. It'll take whatever text you give it above, as long as you select that variable here, and then spit out an MP3 file you can save or just play the audio right here in the shortcut. And that's how I completely generated an audio podcast from a shortcut, not saying a word. It's pretty wild. Now, I did have to upload hours of my own voice to 11 Labs to generate that voice, but you don't have to do that. You can actually use one of their stock AI voices with this API, just like I'm using, and it will still generate an audio file reading whatever text you give it. Now, again, I am a longtime podcaster, 13 plus years. The ethical implications of this are kind of weird. 11 Labs actually gives you the ability to share your professionally cloned voice with others and allow others to use it with your permission. And I imagine one day there might even be maybe nefarious websites that allow you to use clone voices from celebrities or professional voiceover artists and do something like this. Generate an audio file, reading text, maybe even an audiobook using one of those clone voices. Right now, the AI is still not good enough. You can definitely tell right away that this is an AI clone voice. It is not a human being. But a year from now, 2 years from now, 5 years from now, might be indistinguishable. Hopefully the tools to identify AI-generated content develop as fast as the tools to create that AI-generated content. But let me know what you think in the comments. I just wanted to see if I could actually do this and if it worked, and it did, which is pretty wild. But let me know what you think. And before you go, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel Being the end of the year, at least when I'm making this video, I did a whole Apple tier list rating all of Apple's hardware devices that they currently sell at the end of the year. You can check out that video out above here. And if you want to get more into shortcuts but you're not sure where to start, I have an entire Shortcuts 101 video that also gives you 7 easy shortcuts you can download in the video description. You can check out that video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.